Now we are going to discuss with program number this example 3, which is about group selector. What is a group? Like in the previous example, we saw what is a universal selector. In a universal selector, if I declare a style, it is applied for all the elements which I am using, like P, H1, H2. But if I want to choose only for a group of selector one property, then I will call it as group selector. How to do this one? I can show you now here. You can see this example. Look at this example. This is very good for you to see this one to understand. I have given two examples. Can you see here? One is for H1 and P, I am declaring one style. For H2, I am declaring another style. What is the style? You always remember there are two parts in the declaration. This is what? This is called selector part. See, now I will show you. This is what? This one, whatever you are going to have here, this is called what? Selector. So now we are going to have group selector. H1 and P are grouped together. Okay? And what is this part? This part is called declaration part. This part is called declaration part. One minute. This part is called declaration part. From here to here, whatever I am having here is going to be called as what? Declaration part. This is a declaration part. I am having how many properties now here? I am having three properties. I am having three properties. What are they? Number one, property. I have property. And then I have semicolon, I have value. Then I keep semicolon. For the second property, I write like this. Then I declare like this, colon and semicolon. This is a basic idea you should know. Now here, first property is text align, center. Value is center. Now the second property is what? Font size. The value is what? 40 pixels. The third one is what? The property is what? Font color. What is the value? Red. This is what I apply for these two, H1 and P, which are grouped together. But for H2, I am applying another one. Text align right. That means here it was center. I change it to right. Font size was 40 pixels. I make it to 60 pixels. That means the font size will be bigger here. And the font color, I change it to blue. Before it was red. Now come back to this code. If you come to this code, you will see. Now in this code, you can see the idea. I have the program here. You see, I am declaring the same idea here in the style. H1P, same. H2 I declare. Now P, H1, H2. So now you see here H1P. Now this style will be applied where? Now this style will be applied. Paragraph. For paragraph, what will be the style applied? The style will be this one, because P is in this group. Now I have another one, which is what? H1. Which style will be applied for H1? For H1 also, this style will be applied. Why? Because you see that H1 and P are in one group. Why this is happening? This is happening because of what? H1 and P are in one group. Can you see now here? H1 and P. Okay. Now whereas if you go to H2, what will be the style applied? H2, the style will be what? H2 will have the style applied from here. Can you see here? The style is applied, is going to be applied based on what I'd say. The font will be bigger in size, it will be blue in color, and the text will be automatically aligned to the right. I hope this is very, very clear for you, and I believe you don't have any questions on this one. Thank you.